everyone, and welcome to DeLuise Gaming episode 43. It's the 30th of August 2012, and the game in the background is Guild Wars 2. Now, I said last Tuesday that I might not make the episodes of yesterday. This is because I was upgrading my computer and I needed to reinstall Windows and everything that I had on it, and it took a while. So yesterday I made no videos. I'm trying to make up for it. At least today you have a DeLuise Gaming. If I manage, I will make a DeLuise demo. But I also lost my save file of LEGO Batman 2, so I've been playing that one until the point that I can reschedule my episodes. On to the game news. The care package edition of Black Ops 2 will cost 180 euros. The hardened edition is 80 euros. I already talked about these two last Tuesday, and it looked really cool, to be honest. But it's quite a lot to pay 180 bucks for a game plus some extras. And the Secret World has been launched almost 2 months ago, and they already sold 200,000 copies. This is less than the expectations of developer Funcom. They thought that it would be a lot more, but they released it just before Guild Wars 2. And Diablo 3 was released just before it, so just bad timing on their part. An ex-employee of Rare is coming with Tengami. It's a two-dimensional adventure in a world completely made of paper. It is planned to be released in the beginning of 2013, and it will be first released for the iPad, and after that the releases for the PC and Mac will follow. The downloadable content, Dawnguard, for the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, hasn't been delayed on the PlayStation 3 because of hardfire. Some fans were concerned that it wasn't released yet on the PlayStation 3 because of the new expansion, but apparently the teams are working next to each other, so that isn't the cause. And Archos is going to make their first gaming tablet. It will be a 7-inch game tablet with integrated physical buttons, and it should cost less than 150 euros. It will be called the Gamepad. It has quite a lot of keys. At the left they have a D-pad. At the right they have something like that, but then with the A, the B, the X and the Y. Other than that they have analog sticks on each side. A start and a select button or something like that, and two extra buttons. It will have a 1.5 GHz dual core processor and a quad core Mali 400 MP GPU. It will have Android 4.0 and it will be Google certified. So you can download games from the Google Play Store. The multiplayer shooter Gotham City Impostors will be released on the PC in probably a free-to-play model. In the register of Steam, there is a Gotham City Impostors free-to-play trailer. which might just be a leak, seeing as how Warner Brothers hasn't said anything about it. Gotham City Impostors will be a first-person shooter in which two teams of maximum six players will fight against each other. Borderlands 2 will get a season pass for the downloadable content. The season pass will allow you access to all the four downloadable expansions, and the pass will cost $30. This will probably be a little bit less than what they will cost in total, but who knows. The spiritual successor of Total Annihilation has managed to get the Kickstarter goal. It is called Planetary Annihilation, and they needed $900,000, and at the moment they have $940,000 and 15 days left. The new game of L.A. Noire maker, Team Bondi, will be next gen. It will be called War of the Orient, which gives you the place, I guess. Anyway, they are saying that it will be released on the next gen consoles, and we'll see how that turns out. Paradox Interactive, who is known for Crusader Kings 2 and Europe Universalis, has announced the strategy game March of the Eagles. The game will focus on the period in which Napoleon Bonaparte was in power. The game will support a multiplayer of 32 players, in which each country of Europe will be playable. There is a common enemy, namely Napoleon, and his armies will advance as the PlayStation advances. And Stronghold Crusaders 2 has been announced by Firefly Studios. The original Stronghold Crusader was released in 2002, and now they have announced it, the sequel, which is planned for the end of 2013. It will take the players back to the Middle East, and the game will have a new engine for interface of the real-time battles. They also improved the artificial intelligence, so might just be interesting to look at this one. Now, on to the gaming releases. We have a few games for Europe, namely Final Fantasy Dimensions for the Android, iPad and iPhone, Madden NFL 13 for the Xbox 360, the PlayStation 3 and the Wii U, and Tales of Graces for the PlayStation 3. For America, we have Chevrolet Camaro Worldwide for Nintendo 3DS. We have Equator for the Android. We have Final Fantasy Dimensions for the iPhone. We have Forge of Empires Colonial Age for the PC, Fruit Ninja Kinect 8-bit cartridge, Guns of Icarus Online for the Mac, Nightly Adventure for the Android, iPhone, PC and Mac, Mama's 2 Pack for the Wii, Nightfall Martial Law for the iPhone, Order Up for the Nintendo 3DS, Paper Sorcerer for the PC, and iTap Pirate for the iPhone. So quite a lot of games which should release tomorrow. And if that's not enough, I still have Kickstarter today. It's Crafty, which is an online game generator. They need $13,000. They have almost $1,500. And it will be made in HTML5. And it will allow you to play, create and share games on the web. So, it will have a creator tool in which you can use other parts of games or build something completely new. And the second part of it is a gaming portal in which you can distribute and play games. They have a demo online in which some games are already online. The video of the Kickstarter features Pong, Breakout and Space Invaders, which are also available on that site. But the fun thing of this is it allows you to play games, but it also allows you to take those games, change a few rules so that you can play something which you really want to play. I'm not sure how well it allows for creation. Might just be only the basic games which we've been playing for years, but at least you can play with your own rules. They are making the Kickstarter because they want a crowdsource friendly game dev environment, which is Kickstarter to be honest. And they want to use the money for basic living costs, server space, potential legal cost and of course maintenance of the servers. So that was all for today. If you have any questions, you can send them to youtube@heldwife.com. I'll be posting some links on the blog. If you're watching on YouTube, you can find the link to the blog post in the description. I'll try to pick up my normal schedule again, but I'm not sure if I'm able this week. But next week we will be back to normal-ish. See you guys tomorrow.